Knoxville trying to solidify its positioning and claim one of the top four spots and claim home ice advantage in the first round. This game is underway. A fight breaks out immediately. Dylan Denemy with Dwyer Chance in the neutral zone, and this is all about setting the tone, folks. Dylan Denemy sticking up for what happened to Danny Caesar the last time these teams met a week and a half ago in Knoxville. Denemy right now being held onto by a much larger Chance, standing at 6'5". Denemy trying to get a good hold on Chance so he can throw in a right. Denemy loses his helmet, throws in an uppercut on Chance, gets him with a few lefts. Chance has a good stranglehold on Denemy, but Denemy retaliates. Another uppercut over under, several uppercuts in a row. Chance takes a beating, and down he goes. What a way to start this game. The linesman drops the puck. McVay wins the draw. Carlson is harassed by McLean. And they fail to clear it. Turnaround shot. Score! It's 1-0 Macon. Josh Keplinger makes the Ice Bears pay for back-to-back icings and a turnover in their own zone. And it's 1-0 Macon. Just 4:18 into the contest. Palmerville's long shot kicked away. Big rebound stopped by Stiliadis, who knocks it in behind the net. Centered back in front. Stiliadis couldn't find it. Held in. Palmerville long shot redirected into the near corner and picked up by Stefan Brocato, who wheels into the right circle with it, maintaining the puck. Surveys and centers it. Cuthrell scores. It's a one-timer from Scott Cuthrell in the slot, set up by Brocato, and he went top cheddar on Stiliadis over the blocker. And Knoxville's leading scorer has just tallied his 50th point of the season, a tremendous accomplishment. When Cooper Jones backhands it off the wall, gets help from Ili Tallo and Pirog, the latter of whom has cleared it. He joins in the rush with Sean Lynch. Lynch across the blue line, sends it over. Ili Tallo, what a save by Murdaka. He robs his former teammate on the goal line with a brilliant acrobatic stop. Takes it above the right circle, wheels up to the point, slides it across to the half wall on the far side. The Ice Bears come away on a two-on-one. Nielsen, right wing side. Nielsen to the circle, fires and scores. Bryce Nielsen goes bar down on Stiliadis, a shorthanded goal, and has just given the Ice Bears their first lead of this game. It's 2-1 Knoxville. And now it's played by Caleb Cameron up through center. He'll give it to Ili Tallo on his right. Ili Tallo shovels it across. One-timer, save, rebound, score! It's Caleb Cameron with a power play goal, and the Mayhem have drawn level. It's 2-2. Zach Urban is there to take it, and now it's given to Sean Lynch. Out of the box is Arfelt. Here's a chance for Urban to the back end. Centers it. Walter is denied. Point blank by Murdaka. What a save, and he has kept this game tied. Bryce Nielsen has rolled it around his own end wall. One-handed clearing attempt fails. Redirected into the goal. Colton Walter redeems himself. Tips, just a looping shot from above the left circle and has just scored his 20th goal of the season. Macon has regained the lead with 1:25 to go in period two. It's 3-2 Mayhem. On the left side and across the blue line, Cameron spins with it, left half wall, slides it to the right point. Zach Urban gives it across to Pirog, who backhands it into the net from behind the goal line. Steven Pirog scored a goal from a virtually impossible angle, and the Mayhem for the first time tonight have an insurance lead. It's 4-2 Macon. And it's been ripped around by Stiliadis to the far half wall and scooped up in front of the K1 Dashers by Sean Kasarowski and given to Sean Lynch. Lynch to Ili Tallo, given a cross shot, score! That's three assists for Eric Ili Tallo tonight, and Steven Pirog has just scored his third point on the evening. It's 5-2 Macon. Sends it up the middle for J.B. Baker. Baker across the blue line with speed, defended by Campbell, his former teammate at Nichols College. Cuthrell now, right point. Cuthrell with a slap pass, goal line. One-timer is on, stopped by Stiliadis. J.B. Baker's had a lot of good looks tonight, folks. He's making his pro debut, and you wouldn't know it. Arfelt standing in the Beyond Taboo Tattoo penalty box, and there goes Murdaka to the bench. Dwyer Chance down the left side and across the Macon blue line. The puck flutters up in the air, lands in the slot. Here's a wrist shot by Sargis. He scores. Garrett Sargis with a power play strike with 7 seconds left on the Macon penalty kill, which Oscar Arfelt was serving for a hold, and Knoxville still has some life in it yet. This game is not over. 5-3 is now your score. 3:09 to go in the third period. That will count as a power play goal. Tries to backhand it to somebody. Gets it to Bombardier, who's also behind the net. 7 seconds and 5-4, and that's going to do it. The Mayhem have just cleared it, and they will take the 2 points in regulation tonight. 5-3, the final here at the Macon Centerplex in this Tuesday night makeup contest. Macon's last matchup against Knoxville this season. And they have ended the season series on a high note.